I'm Tiger Stove. I'm going to show you what it takes to study some of the most dangerous and harmless ecosystems on Earth.
Alright now, that's a doozy.
I'm going to make it through a day of challenges and assorted ecosystems where someone would not last 2 seconds without the knowledge taught by Mr. Skeeter.
Look at this. Oh, don't get away. Alright.
This time, I'm in the suburbs of a typical backyard of someone's house in Edmonton. I'll be taking on its intense ecosystems.
We've made it to the ecosystem. Look at that.
Looking at the abiotic factors, organisms.
Oh my, look at this grass.
And talk about the threats to biodiversity. Facing all the requirements of the rubric.
As you can see, I'm on my way to Stranger's Backyard and Ecosystem of Edmonton. Now, I'm going in an all-terrain vehicle going about 5 miles per hour. Now, I have to execute this jump perfectly as to avoid minor scrapes or burns or even death. Alright.
This is one jump I do not want to mess up. One flaw, and I would be in urgent need of some band-aids, or I could even die.
Alright, here we go. Yeah, okay, we're good.
I made the jump with nothing but a small incision on my baby toe. Now I start to wonder, what will I be able to find in this ecosystem?
Come with me. We've made it to the ecosystem. Look at that. As you can tell, there are a bunch of abiotic factors influencing the organisms that live here.
Don't do this at home. This is extremely dangerous.
Alright. Look what we have here. This is sunlight. It's one of the main sources of energy for plants and grasses to grow. Let's take a closer look at it, shall we?
Sunlight is a necessity for organisms to live in an ecosystem. It is our main energy source. It is used by plants for photosynthesis. Without the sun, there would be no plants. Therefore, organisms other than producers would not be able to feed off plants and grass. The sun also provides warmth and is a huge influence on organisms. There seems to be a good amount of sunlight here, perfect to live in.
All right, let's see what else we can find. Look what we've got here. We've got a bunch of soil for ants and worms and other insects to live in.
Soil is also a top abiotic factor here. There are many organisms that need it, like grass and worms. Organisms can burrow into the soil to avoid harsh weather, which is common in an ecosystem like this one.
Oh my, look here, there's a garage. Now when it rains and snows or other heavy weather, other organisms and insects like to hide in here for some shelter. Let's go take a peek inside.
Rain is also important for an ecosystem like this one filled with organisms. Without water, this place would be bone dry, and a bunch of organisms would have to evacuate, and plants wouldn't be able to do photosynthesis. There seems to be a good amount of oxygen around here, which is really good, because oxygen is an important component of life. All living organisms need oxygen to live, including plants. Without oxygen, everything in this ecosystem would die in a matter of hours. There are a lot of rocks in here, which is a good place for organisms to hide. They can use it as shelter for different temperatures, and under a hot sun like this, it's a nice place to keep cool in the shade.
Get down! There. We've just encountered a forest organism. Grass.
Grass is one of the organisms that live in this ecosystem. It is a producer, so it gets its energy from the sun. Plants may compete with one another to get a good source of sunlight and nutrients from the soil.
Now, when organisms eat each other, only 10% of the energy from its original source is transferred over. Now, I'm hot, sweaty, and have massive diarrhea. I'm a little bit hungry, so I'm going to try and make this grass my dinner.
Don't do this at home. This is extremely dangerous, and I'm a professional and get paid to do this stuff.
I got it. Have some dinner. Look at that. This is gonna be my supper. But it's not time for that now, so I'm gonna stash it away in my pocket. Let's go look around some more. Look at this. Oh my. Oh my. Oh, don't get away. Alright. This is an earthworm. This is the second. Oh, slippery little guy. This is the second organism we've seen in this ecosystem now. Alright? I would eat it because it's full of protein and nutrients. And some dirt and poop, but that's fine. So I'm just going to put it back. This little guy away. Here we go. Another one. Okay.
Earthworms are decomposers. They break down detritus and then convert it into inorganic chemicals that can be recycled as mineral nutrients for primary producers like plants to use again.
My oh my, I am pooped. What I learned from a wise man once, you take your phone, take your cell phone out, find a spot of sunlight, and you can make a phone dial out of it. It's like a sundial, but you guessed it, with a phone. Alright, from the angle of this shadow and the sun, I'd say it's about 8 o'clock. It's about time we make camp for the night and make us some dinner.
It is essential to make camp in these types of ecosystems, because you can get very sleepy from studying them.
Whoa! Did you see that? It's a grasshopper! That was really scary. I'm not gonna lie to you guys. I think I might have soiled myself a little. Yeah, I definitely did. Alright, well, I couldn't manage to start a fire and cook my dinner. So I think I'll just take this grasshopper and take a bite.
The grasshopper is a primary consumer. It feeds off of producers like plants and grass.
It's good, so delicious. Let's move on. Get down! It's a godless snake. They are harmless to humans, but can cause serious injury and death. Alright, these snakes are not venomous. We should pretend they are to impress the ladies. Alright, let's take a closer look.
Snakes are secondary consumers. They feed off of insects like the grasshopper. They compete with other gardener snakes for food. Snakes are predators. They are carnivores that prey on insects and small animals, but they could be fallen prey as well.
Oh, broke my stick! Alright, there's nothing else to do here. So let's get out of here and keep making our camp. Alright.
Don't do this at home. This is extremely dangerous, and I am a professional.
Whoa! Look! Do you see that? Look, it's a crow.
Crows are tertiary consumers. They eat worms, grasshoppers, and even gardener snakes. Crows are one of the top predators in this ecosystem. They compete with other birds as well, feeding off on these organisms on the ground.
Now that looks like dinner. Camp is done for the night. The habitats around the ecosystem look like there's been a lot of fragmentation happening here. There's a lot of man-made structures, like this garage here, and this home. As of now, if an invasive species were to come here, it would reproduce at an exponential rate and increase the competition for food around here, as scarce as the resources already may be.
It's 7 o'clock on the dot.
Studying ecosystems makes me hungry. Let's go see what we can get from this house here. Wait for me out here.
Try to do this as quietly. See what's happening.
That did not go as planned.